In the previous video, we have presented the basic quantities of the direction coupler, and we said one of the main quantities which describe the performance of the direction coupler is the directivity. And we said that the directivity is the quantity of the coupled signal to the isolated port compared to the coupled signal to the coupled port. And usually the value of the directivity is very small. So if you are talking in terms of dB, so 20 log the directivity is very large value in dB. We say that the directivity of a direction coupler is a measure of the coupler's ability to separate forward and reverse wave components. Applications of direction couplers often require higher or high value of directivity, more than 35 dB or greater than this. Actually, poor directivity will limit the accuracy of using the direction coupler as a reflectometer and can cause variation in coupled power level from a coupler when there is even a small mismatch on the through line. The directivity generally cannot be measured directly because it involves very low signal level that can be masked by a coupled power from reflected power or on the through arm. So we are going to present a measuring mechanism for coupler directivity. Assuming that we are talking about a three-port network, port 1, port 2, and port 3, and the conventional direction is the bar is going from port 1 to port 2, and the coupled signal is going from port 1 to port 3. In this case, the directivity is the bar going from port 2 to port 3, which is, as I said, is very small value, and it is required to determine the bar going from port 2 to port 3. We are going to start with measuring the coupling. The coupling is the forward direction, and we are going to calculate the bar at port 3 due to the incident bar at port 1. So we are going to connect the direction coupler in its forward biasing such that the power input bar at port 1, the load at port 2, and the measuring bar meter is connected to port 3. In this case, the coupled bar BC would equal the magnitude of the coupling squared, C squared, multiplied by B incident. Or in other words, we can say that the coupling coefficient C equals the 10 to the power minus C in dB over 20. Now, assuming that this load has small reflection, it is not completely matched. It has small reflection, and this reflection is unknown right now. So we have two unknowns. We have the directivity as an unknown and the reflection coefficient of the load as another unknown. This means that if we created two equations in these two unknowns, we can solve these two equations to obtain the two unknowns. Actually, I'm not interested in the value of the gamma. I'm interested in the reflection of the directivity D. Now, to obtain the directivity D, we are going to connect such direction coupler in reverse direction, such that the input power will be connected to port 2 and the load will be connected to port 1. This configuration. In this case, the input power will be connected to port 2 and the load is connected to port 1. In this case, the bar is going from port 2 to port 1 to the load, And through the directivity, some of the power is going to port 3. Should be noted here, this through the directivity, not through the cable. The reflected signal, part of the reflected signal is coupled to port 3 through the coupling coefficient C. At the beginning, let us see how much power is going from port 2 to port 3. We know that the power at 3 due to 1 V3 over V1 is coupling square. And the power at 2 due to port 1 is the directivity square or D square. This means that the power B3 over B2, which is B3 over B1 multiplied by B1 over B2, which is B3 over B2, the power at 3 over the power at 2, would equal the coupling squared over the directivity squared. B3 over B2 would be C squared over D squared. Or in other words, in terms of voltage, the volt at 3 over the voltage over 2 would be C over D. Okay? Now, we see that the magnitude of the directivity D is actually 10 to the power d in dv over 20, which is usually much greater than 1. In this case, the total power at port 3 is a combination going from port 2, which is c over d multiplied by v naught, or v input, c over d multiplied by v input, plus the reflected power from the root, which equals C multiplied by the reflection coefficient, multiplied by the phase shift e to the power minus jc. Now, by moving the load, making the load a sliding load, such that it is moving across the line here, we are going to change the value of theta. If we are looking at the summation of the signal coming from 2 and the signal coming from 1 at port 3, we can find it as a complex summation. The first component is the value of C over D, and the second component is C multiplied by the magnitude of gamma multiplied of E to the power minus JC. Now, by changing the position of the load with respect to the transmission line, we can change the value of theta. So, the maximum will occur when these two components are in phase. So, the maximum value will be C over D plus C multiplied by modulus of gamma. And the minimum value will occur when these two components will be out of phase. So, in the case of out of phase, this would be C over D minus C multiplied by gamma. So, in the complex plane, the output voltage at the port 3, it can be represented by the vector quantity C over D multiplied by V input plus the vector quantity C multiplied by gamma multiplied by VI, where this would be C multiplied by the magnitude of gamma multiplied by VI multiplied by e to the power minus jc. For the different values of theta, when theta equals 0, this will be the summation CD plus C gamma. When theta equals y, this would be CD minus C gamma. This means that the output voltage at port 3 will vary by sliding the load from maximum value to minimum value. Okay? And the maximum value is V naught equal VR multiplied by C over D plus C multiplied by gamma, and the minimum value is V naught multiplied by C over D minus C multiplied by gamma. And actually the value of gamma, as I said, it is very small. The load is nearly matched. It is not completely matched, but it is nearly matched. From this, we have two relations, the minimum power and the maximum power at both 3. The minimum power equals P input multiplied by C over D minus C multiplied by the modulus of gamma squared. And V maximum is V input multiplied by C over D plus C multiplied by modulus of gamma squared. On the other hand, for the forward case, the output power, it was the V coupled, which is C squared multiplied by V input die. From this, we can obtain two definitions, capital M and small m. Capital M is the value of the forward coupled power to the value of maximum power in the case of reverse excitation. So this would be C squared multiplied by B input over B input multiplied by C over B minus C multiplied by gamma squared. We can eliminate C squared with this C squared. So capital M, which is the direct coupled power to the maximum inverse coupled power, equals the magnitude of D over 1 plus the magnitude of gamma. Sorry, I'm talking about B maximum, the magnitude of gamma D squared. On the other hand, we can say that small m is the value of B maximum over B minimum, the maximum measured power in the reverse to the minimum measured power at the reverse. This is small m. By dividing this by this, we can obtain a small m is 1 plus modulus of gamma multiplied by d over 1 minus modulus of gamma multiplied of d. This all squared. Actually, the value of bc, b maximum, and b minimum are already measured quantities. So the value of capital M and the value of small m are already calculated. So these are measured values. The unknown now is the value of D and the value of the modulus of gamma. So we have two equations in two unknowns. The two equations, this equation equals capital M and this equation capital small equals small m. By solving these two equations, we can obtain the value of D and the value of gamma. As I said, we are interested in the value of D. So the value of D in this case equals capital M multiplied by 2 multiplied by small m over small m plus 1, where m is the coupled power in the forward direction over the maximum coupled power in the reverse direction, and small m is the maximum coupled power in the reverse direction to the minimum coupled power in the reverse direction. By doing this, we can obtain the value of the directivity of the direction. This is how to measure the directivity of a directional couple. Okay? Alright.